Sandra, today I am going. Let's go. Today I'm going to be making a slime. So, not just any slime, butter slime. If you're new, subscribe and hit that like button. My name is Sandra and I do awesome videos, if you guys think so. So, today I'm going to be making butter slime. And I already have the glue on it because, like, this glue is kind of hard to open, so I already did it before. And yeah. Also, I have a spoon, obviously. I have this air-dried clay, which you could buy at any dollar store near you. It's like this, any color, and it's like this, with these little bristles. And basically, it's stretchy, so it's good to make butter slime. So, as usual, is it still hot? Yes, it's still hot. It's still hot. Okay, so as usual, I got our borax and our Skittles, because the world needs Skittles to survive. So, yeah. Okay, let's get started. Oh my god, Skittles. Okay. Now we have our glue here. It looks so liquidy and chunky. Maybe it's because it's from the dollar store. Who knows? I'm gonna start off with 2 teaspoons of the wax liquid, and we're gonna mix until all mixed. Yeah, this glue like looks really chunky and weird. Like it looks like it's already coming together. It's weird, like. Or it kind of looks like marshmallow paste or something. Also, if you hear people walking by, I told like people not to or anything, because I'm doing it in the hallway because you know me has no good lighting, so yeah, it's true. In my videos I never have good lighting, so yeah. And I bet she just got a victory royale or something. Sorry if you hear my cousins like yelling or something. I told them to be quiet. This like gets all like coming together, but now it's getting a bit liquidier. So I don't know if that's a word, liquidier. So yeah. All right, guys, I'm back and we've only finished the, we've let it set for a bit, but now it's kind of looking like real glue, so. Hopefully, 2 teaspoons will work. I have to check that. I really hope this works, but I bought 3 bottles of glue because I didn't know this would be, I didn't think this would be enough. It doesn't really look enough, but we could use like half the air dry clay if it's not enough. I got the dollar store glue, the school glue, and it's washable, so I don't feel like it will work as well, but like, I don't know, maybe it will. Just a bit to like see if it like gets strained or something. So yeah, okay, so I think this is strained a bit. So it still looks like really globby. So no, still thing. Who knows? Maybe the fifth one would be a top. Like me. Okay, anyways. Hey. it's kind of coming together a bit more. The spoon is bending. That's what I've gotten so far. So yeah, this is so far what I got. And, also I haven't been making videos in a long time. So like, I just thought I'd make a slime vid or something. Also, I can't put the slime on the floor, wood floors. So. Okay. Maybe the 7 will work. I shouldn't have put a 7. I feel like I should have only stuck with a 6. Because now it's kind of breaking, so. Ryan, can you get me another blue bottle downstairs? No, in that room. Where you can't see him because it's not allowed to be shown. But, Okay. Give me it. Goodbye. Close the door. That was my little cousin Ryan. If it gets like way too thin, just add up like 3 little plops of glue in it. And oh god. Ew, okay. It should like thicken out and not be so tough to play with anymore because you added too much bark. So I'm saying, well, I added too much bark. But if you do the same thing, then see, now it's coming back together like the glue. And we just gotta mix until slime. So as I see it coming together, I just usually put I usually put one more just to pick up around the edges. So messy. I should have brought my tongue. Don't tell my mother. So, now I just pick up around the sides and we mix until, and the air dry clay should soften it out. So it's okay if it's like a bit too overactivated, but like not all the way, you know what I'm saying? This spoon is so tough to work. This spoon breaks on me. Now, if it's like coming off the spoon easily, then that's how you know your slime is done. It just needs a bit more kneading. Now we just knead until the slime is finished. It's like everyone's classical first slime. Oh god, it's so sticky. Be aware of your stickiness, guys. And if you hear like crunchy sounds like this, wait. It's okay because it kind of sounds like it's ripping, but don't worry guys, it's not. Trust me. It's gonna be a little sticky at first as when it's coming off your hands, but that's fine. Because you guys will see what I do at the end. Now put it back in and again. If it's not sticking to the bowl anymore, be aware of, don't take it out. Trust me, guys. Don't take it out. People say it's not sticking to the bowl anymore, but you still have to knead it while it's sticky. So it like doesn't stick, but it's still sticking to your hand, but it's not sticking to the bowl. You know what I'm saying? See, look, it comes off my hands, but it's still sticky. It's kind of like a dull texture. You just need to mix until forming. So yeah. I will be back. Okay, so guys, it is cooperating now, as you could see. But now it's still a bit sticky. And what I do is I just dip the end of it inside the borax like this. I just dip it really quick and I mix it into the thing so that it like stops being sticky. Now it should be kneading like so. And then, just take off my hand now. What I do when I turn my hand is I take a little piece and just like so. Guys, so I finished and feels really nice. Get a close up. It looks really nice. Oh my god, it looks like a face. It looks really nice and feels really nice. So if you listen, it's a lot of like bubbles. And I think this is a really good sign because if you look at when it flips, it should look like shiny and like matte at the same time. That's how you know it's a good sign. But so you guys, I actually like this sign. So yeah, it's a really nice texture and it has a really nice feel to it. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? And I'm just gonna stick it on here and let it sit for a bit. So bye. Okay guys. So this is how it looks now. Now I think we should start putting the clay in. I kneaded the clay and I put lotion in it before I started the video so that like, God, this is really sticky. I'll be back. Okay guys, it is time to nail put this. It is already kind of like hardening, so we should like knead it a bit. I'm getting itchy. Hello. Wait, let me make a better one. Hello, this is my finger. What's your wrong thumb? So, I'm gonna like, you're supposed to put it in when the slime is done. You're not supposed to mix it. Okay guys, so I've just mixed it in like a little bit of pieces of clay. Now we're just gonna, oh my god, it's sticky. Okay, as you can see, it's like kind of blending. We're just gonna squish the little pieces. Okay, so this is what it looks like now that I've mixed a few pieces in. So, yeah. Okay, so now I got this piece over here that we're just gonna need a bit. It like feels so weird when you find the little clay bumps. And yeah, oh my god. After I mix this all in, I'm gonna put the rest of the clay, like just to form the texture. This is forming the color right now. There's a lot of material steps. This is like amazing. Like Karina Garcia should be shook. Karina Garcia is quaking. Like this is so good. I'm joking. The slime is like not back. It's starting to get like that kind of clay texture to it. So. Sorry if you guys hear my cousins. They're like really loud. Like. Really, really long. Anyways, so I'm just gonna mix these now. I kinda wanna see if I put a skill in this, what would happen? Okay, now that we have formed the color, take this. Put this in here, and we're gonna sort of like mix it in. So I'm gonna put it here for you guys to see. Oh my god, everything is sticking. The switch floor is kind of hurting now. Okay, so kind of forming the like shape now and the color. But it isn't forming the texture just yet. This looks like my tie-dye shirt. Okay, time to put the rest of the entire plate and see what happens. Hopefully, or I'll put half. So, I'll be back when I'm done mixing. Last piece. Okay guys, this is my butter slash fluffy slime. And it's a bit too like sticky. So I'm just gonna, oh my god. I forgot about this white piece right here. Yeah. I just take some. Okay. I think we should put like not any tablespoon, just like put the little access, like dip it in, take it out and put it in. So that we're not getting a spoon or too much that we might not need. And then we're just gonna mix. Hopefully, the egg part not to be sticky. I feel like this came out more of a. It feels like a butter slime. Like, it feels like really nice, like a really soft butter slime, but it's kind of sticky. But then, like, when you stretch it, it forms into like a fluffy slime. So, I guess this is a butter slash fluffy slime recipe I just gave you. So, yeah. Also, I've once made an icy slime, cream cheese slime, butter slime, and fluffy slime all in one container. So I might do a video on that using these glues. So yeah, I think we should add a bit, like just where the spoon shape is, because I left a little spoon shape. You can see it over here. It's where it is. I want to put a bit more borax. There we go. So I just put a bit. Hopefully this will like not be super sticky. But it might also take away the, nope, it didn't take away the fluffy slime texture. Okay. I feel like this is a really nice slime, and you don't need color for this or anything, because like the clay forms like color and sparkles. So ooh, sticky, boom, sticky. I just find So now, as you can see, it's not that sticky anymore. And yeah, like right when I touch it, it just falls off my hand. And yeah, so this is what it turned out to be. Get a close view on that. It looks purple, but it's pink. I promise. This is what my smart turned out to be. Also, when you hit it once, all the stickiness comes off. So yeah, I hope you like this video and take this recipe that I gave you to make a butter slash fluffy slime. Just put it in this container. Yeah.